Hello everyone, welcome to Aditap. So in today's session, we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is the repo rate and the reverse repo rate. Okay, so we will be discussing the definitions, the differences, as well as what are the effect of these in the inflation and the growth of the economy and why they are very important from the exam's point of view. Okay, so now starting with the session, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are new to the channel and join our Telegram channel for the PDF of this session. And you can get the link of the Telegram channel in the description box below. So now, here is the reason that why this topic is very important, because in previous year paper of RBI grade B in 2018, the question, three questions or more than three questions was asked about the repo rate. And here, as you can see, these three are the questions that were asked. Okay. A question was asked in which you needed to answer a question. We will discuss the question after we have discussed the monetary policy and the types of monetary policy, okay? But in the 2021, in the 2021 also, a question related to the repo rate was asked, or where you had to have the basic knowledge of the repo rate to answer this question. So now, starting with the meaning of the repo rate. See, what is the repo rate? In the simple terms, we can say repo rate is the rate, or it is the rate at which the bank is taking loans from the RBI. Okay, let's say it is taking the loan of 10 crores. It is taking the loan from the, see, RBI is the banker of the banks. For the banks, what are the services that is provided by the banks? They are taking the deposits and they are giving the loans. Similarly, RBI is the banker of the banks. That is, it is taking the deposits from the banks and it is giving the loans to the banks. So here we can say that repo rate is the rate at which the RBI is giving the loans to the banks. So now if the RBI is giving the loan, see what the banks do. They take our collateral, they take the house as a collateral or the land as a collateral. So RBI is also taking a collateral from the banks to give the loans. Here the collateral that is taken from the banks is the government securities. Okay. That is trusted by the RBI, and the RBI has said that I will take the government securities as a collateral. So see, government securities, what are they? The government bonds, we can say the treasury bills. So the bank is giving collateral as a government securities. Next is repo rate. See, what is the meaning of repo rate? It is, full form is purchase option. So that is, it is a forward agreement. It is a forward agreement or contract between the RBI and the bank. See, the bank is giving the Reserve Bank of India is giving the loan and the bank is giving the collateral as a government securities. So now the bank is promising the RBI, it is promising the RBI that I will repurchase my government security. I will take this collateral back and I will give your money back to you. I will give back the money with the repo rate or with the interest that I have to give. So I will give your money back. I will also give the interest that I have to give on the money that I have taken, and I will take the, I will repurchase the government securities that I am giving you in the repo period. Repo period can be overnight. Usually it is one day only. Okay, overnight the loan is taken and in one day it is returned. It can be term period also. Term repo also 7 days, mostly it is 7 days, for 7 days it is taken. I hope you have understood that it is a two-way process, that the RBI is giving the loan, the bank is giving the collateral. Then the agreement is made that I will take back, the bank will take back the collateral and it will repay the loan with some interest payment, that is the repo rate, on the repo rate. And currently what is the repo rate? It is 4%. I have told you in the finance current affairs video that current repo rate is 4% and current reverse repo rate is 3.35%. Okay. So now here in the reverse repo rate, what is happening? Now the RBI is taking the deposits from the bank. The bank is giving the deposits. Let's say 10 crore. Deposit is given to the RBI. Now the RBI is giving the collateral to the bank. Now why the collateral is given? Because the reverse repo rate, or the, this is said to be secure deposits, that your deposits are secured with us. You can take this collateral. The RBI provides collateral, that is government securities, to the banks, who is depositing their money, who is giving the money in a way to the RBI, and the RBI is giving the collateral, or we can say government securities, as a secured deposits, to make it the secure deposits. Okay, next is The reverse repo rate is the reverse repurchase option where a forward contract is made. Maybe it is a 1 day or 7 days. So it is a forward period it is an agreement where the RBI and the bank are promising, it is a contract between the both, and the bank is promising that in the future it will resell the government securities that it has taken as a collateral. That I will resell in the future, I will resell the government securities that I have taken from you, okay, which you have provided to me. I will give you back your government securities after you have given back my deposit after you have given the reverse repo rate, that is the payment, the percentage also with the deposit. Then I will give back the, I will resell the government securities to you if you are giving me this. So this is also for a reverse repo period, okay? It can be 1 day, 7 days. I hope you have understood this also. It is also a very simple process. The bank is depositing their money with the RBI. The RBI is giving some collateral to the bank for the trust, or we can say it is a secured deposit that the Reserve Bank of India is doing. When the payment has to be done, when the deposit has to be returned, it has to be returned with some interest payment. That is the payment on the percentage of reverse repo rate. Okay, so now I will come to the third slide where we will see the differences between the two. So here the first difference is that the interest rate in repo transaction, or the repo rate, is a collateralized loan in the money market. Money market is the short-term market, okay? Short-term borrowing market especially. So collateralized loan, because the RBI is taking the collateral from the bank, and then it is giving the loan. So it is a collateralized loan. Here it is a secured deposit. It is a secured deposit in the money market, in a short-term market. Money market is the short-term market. Okay. Now, next is short-term borrowing rate determined through outright sale of securities. So bank is doing what? It is selling the securities to the RBI, and there is a commitment that the bank will buy its security back, buy the collateral bank after giving the money, after giving the payment also, the repo rate, on the repo rate in a specified future date. That is a forward contract, we can say. Here the short-term lending rate determined outright purchase of securities that the bank is purchasing. See, if the bank is giving the deposit or RBI is taking the loan, we can say. So here the usually it is said that bank is depositing. Okay, in that term I am saying. So short-term lending rate determined outright purchase of securities. So the bank is purchasing the securities, or bank is taking the security, taking the government securities, and the bank is committing that I will sell the securities when you have given my deposit back, when you have given the percentage also, the reverse repo rate also. So the bank is saying that I have given your government security, I have taken your government security, and I have given my deposits to you. I will give back the government security that is I have taken after taking my deposit and after taking the reverse repo rate also. So next one is, see, higher than the reverse repo rate. Of course, the repo rate will be higher, because repo rate is the rate at which the RBI is giving loan, and the loan is given at a higher rate and the deposit is taken at a lower rate. So the reverse repo rate is lower than the repo rate, because the deposits of course are taken at a lower rate. Last point is that the repo injects liquidity in the economy. See, here we are not talking about the repo rate. Here we are talking about the repo transaction now, in the fourth point. In the repo transaction, what is happening? That the repo is, see, what does repo do? It is injecting the liquidity in the economy. How? Because the money is going from the RBI to the bank, and the collateral is going from the bank to the RBI. So money is flowing towards the bank. And what will the bank do with the money? It will give the loans, it will do some investments and all. So the liquidity is being injected in the economy. It is going towards the economy. While in this case, the reverse repo sucks liquidity. It is taking the deposit, it is taking the money from the bank. Okay, so it is sucking the liquidity, absorbing the liquidity. The government securities are going from the RBI to the bank, and the bank is giving the money to the RBI. So the money is going towards the RBI, that is going away from the bank, which would have done the transactions with that money. So rather than bank, the money is going to the RBI. Okay, so this is the differences between the two, which you have to remember. The money market, this last point especially, is very important. Now we can come that how the repo rate and the reverse repo rate can affect the economy by controlling the inflation or by providing the growth in the economy. See, the reverse repo rate as well as the repo rate, both will increase in the case of controlling the inflation. Okay, if the repo rate is increasing, then the interest payments will be increased by the banks, because if they are getting at higher interest at the higher rate, they will also provide the loans. The banks will also provide the loans at a higher interest rate. So the when the interest rate will increase, the cost of borrowing has increased. When the cost of borrowing has increased, people will take less loans. When they are taking less loans for the buying the car, for buying the houses, means the demand has reduced. When the demand has reduced, the inflation will reduce. Okay. In the case of the reverse repo rate, when the reverse repo rate has increased, the banks will start depositing their money with the bank, with the RBI, because RBI has increased the depositing rate. Because the RBI has increased the rate, and the banks think that, wow, it is a secure option, that RBI will of course give my money back, so why I take the risk? I will just deposit my money with the RBI, where I am getting higher interest rate now on the deposits. So the banks will deposit and will not lend much. The loans will reduce. Okay, in the case of the growth, the repo rate and the reverse repo rate both will decrease. If it will decrease, the interest rate, that is the cost of loans, will decrease, because the banks think that I am getting the loans easily, I am getting the loans in the less interest rate, so I should give the loans also in the less interest rate. Due to which what happens, the cost of borrowing has decreased. When the interest rate has decreased, when with the decrease in the repo rate, and now the loans, the taking of the loan will increase, the demand will increase, which will increase the supply also. And so the growth has increased, the churning of the process has increased. By decreasing the depositing rate, the banks will feel that, why should I give the money to the RBI when it is giving such decreased rate, okay, such less interest to me. So I will rather pay to the, I will rather give the loans, or I will invest somewhere else. So the money will start circulating, which would have gone to the deposits. The money, that money will also start circulating in the economy. The transactions will begin, the demand will increase. So I hope you have understood the reverse repo rate and the repo rate. These are the people that have given the right answers in the previous of the questions of the previous session. Timothy, Harish and IT, you have done really well, I must say. Okay. So now this was the question where I thought the kids have gotten confused, the students have gotten confused. Okay. So see, first is fiscal deficit is equal to this. I have told you in the previous session, it is also equal to the total borrowings, the fiscal deficit, because only the borrowings are left now. So borrowings will be equal to the fiscal deficit. How are we completing this deficit? How are we paying this deficit back? By taking borrowings. So the borrowings will be equal to this. Now how is this equal? All of the above is the answer. So now I have to explain you that how this is also equal to fiscal deficit. See, revenue deficit is equal to revenue expenditure minus revenue receipts plus, this is the, so we can write it, revenue expenditure minus revenue receipts plus capital expenditure. Plus capital expenditure. Instead of RD, I have written this, okay? Plus capital expenditure. So RE plus CE is total expenditure. The revenue expenditure and the capital expenditure is total expenditure minus revenue receipts minus non-debt creating capital receipts. So non-debt creating capital receipts minus and minus, we will take it together. We will take it as a common, and we will write total expenditure minus revenue receipts plus non-debt creating capital receipts. So this is the formula that I told you in the previous session also, na? Just the examiner has given you it in a different form. So you don't have to get confused. You try to understand and you try to form a series like this. And you could have just seen that A is right, the C is also right. So all of the above is the answer that I must give. So through that also, through the process also, you do not have to even solve it. You can just see that A is right, C is right. So of course the answer will be all of the above. Here the answer was the primary deficit, which most of the students have given right. So now, thank you very much. I hope you have understood the repo rate and the reverse repo rate and the different terms, that how is it sucking the liquidity or how the liquidity is flowing into the market. Thank you very much. If you have any query, you can mail us here or you can contact us through this number. Thank you very much.